another 100 BBC broadcast staff to name us something memorable about Philip Garood. Sarah, let's ask you.
Phil Garood. Lots of dirt for sure on Phil Garood. I can't think of any off the top of my head there, but he does like semi-naked podium dancing in front of hundreds of people at Christmas parties. He's very good at that. And he had a very sharp, meteoric, in fact, rise in the department from...
His career, yes.
from press bats clerk to editor, but he had another title in the beginning, Janet. Yes, bizarrely, his first ever job was as relief assistant. But didn't he do something on international channels, Caroline? I think
he was responsible for Eastern Europe.
All of it?
Maybe just half.
Thank you again, the Fairbairns of Ealing. Let's play another round of Family Fortunes with Caroline and Mike. Please join me. We asked 100 BBC broadcast staff to name another editor who's leaving this Christmas.
Wayne Jacobson.
Wayne Jacobson. Oh, Mike.
An editor. Francis Ottaway.
Francis Ottaway's a good answer. Let's play Family Fortunes. We asked 100 BBC broadcast staff to name us something memorable about Francis Ottaway. Let's start with you, Dave.
Now, Francis was one of the founder members of the Albertinis, for those people who remember. The Albertinis were a group of people who spent most of their afternoons and evenings at Albertines. And Francis had a bit of a fascination with lesbians. In fact, there was one occasion where she and the Albertinis were down at Albertines when a drunken lesbian crawled over all the tables and chairs to try and snog Francis. Talking of which...
Francis does like snogging, doesn't she? I seem to remember there are quite a few engineers she's been through at Christmas parties various that I'm sure she'd rather we didn't notice, but I think we should.
Y2K. Ah, that was a memorable occasion with Francis. Yeah, she memorably left the BBC's Y2K contingency plans outside a pub in Great Portland Street. Before Y2K, obviously.
So there's a common theme with Frances and alcohol.
Oh, yeah, that's right. She does like to celebrate, doesn't
Loves
she?
Loves her birthdays.
Loves birthdays. Remember that time she left Gabby a present?
I do. She left us several presents.
Several presents. What was it now?
So she got very, very drunk, went into an office, left a pair of glasses.
That's right. A pile of puke. And there was...
It was a vibrator!
It must mean a dildo.
Yeah, yes. And she got the glasses back.
She didn't get the puke back, she didn't want it, and I don't know what happened to the vibrator.
I think Gabby's never given it back.
New batteries, please. More words of disgrace from the 80s of Ealing.
I'm sorry, we have to interrupt the broadcast there. Apparently, Francis Ottaway was never an editor. And come to think of it, I'm not sure about Gibbo.
And it's our final round of disgraceful family fortunes. Let's meet our two next contenders, Janet, Bitty, and Stan! Bitty?
Computer says no.
Oh, let's play. Stan, Janet, we asked 100 BBC broadcast people to name us another editor who's leaving.
Neil Caldicott.
Something we don't know.
What?
Janet?
Paul Sapsford.
Paul Sapsford is a correct answer. Let's play Family Fortunes. You know the score by now. We asked 100 people and BBC broadcast staff to name something memorable about Paul Sapsford. Is there anything about Paul Sapsford?
Can we confer?
You can confer. You can have 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, out. Opt back.
Pass it over.
Okay, we'll pass it over to the 80s of Ealing to name us something memorable about Paul Sapsford.
Well, he was once, he interviewed a guy for a presentation operator's job and asked him why working all this time in radio suddenly he wanted to apply for a television post. And the guy said, television?
So let's see if the Fairbairns have, after all that deliberation, come up with something new about Paul Sapsford. So, Sarah leading the Fairbairns, any news about Paul Sapsford?
Well, I think we might have something. Didn't he have a penchant for wearing shorts? You know, coming in shorts the minute the sunlight peeped out from behind a tree?
No, that was Simon Penn.
Oh, damn, that was Simon
Penn. Actually, who was it who came to work wearing black tie and evening dress?
No,
that was Phil, wasn't
yeah.
it?
That yeah, that was Phil Garud, yeah. Paul. Yeah,
chased a present around the donut?
Simon Smith,
yeah.
Yeah.
And who's the goat in the multi-story car park?
No, that was the red shower area.
Oh, sorry.
No. But he does wear some very smart clothes.
Oh, he's just gorgeous.
Lovely legs.
Lovely eyes.
Best looking guy in broadcast.
The eyelashes to die.
Beautiful eyes. Yeah. Movie star eyes. Pull him and eat your heart out.
Ah, well, there we are. Some memorable words about Paul Sapsford. Thank you to the Fairbairns of Ealing. Thank you to the ADs of Ealing, to the Fairbairns of Ealing, for joining us on this very special Editors Edition, or Ex-Editors Edition, of Family Fortunes. And trust me, I'm sure there's going to be plenty more Family Fortunes next year.
Hi, I can't believe you're all leaving. It seems like only yesterday that you arrived and I trained some of you. You found the escape tunnel. Could you tell me where it is, please? Have a nice time. Have a lovely retirement. See you soon. Bye.
Good luck. And I'm going to miss you all and hopefully it'll be my turn soon. Bye.
I can't get better. 3 leaving dues. That's far too many for 1 lifetime. Bye. Good luck.
John Allen, I've known you many, many years. I remember you very, very well as a real blue-eyed boy trainee at Bush House. Come to think of it, you've not changed a bit. Joe McPhee, you were my first ever assistant editor here at Television Centre. You taught me everything that I know as a network director, but you never did teach me about being a bunny girl, so if you'd like to get back to me on that one, it could be too late. Francis, you're one of the best mates that I've had here. You're fantastic. I'm going to miss you desperately. And who's going to be my partner in crime now that you're going? Phil, cheekiest press back clerk I have ever known. And given that you joined the ranks of people like Mandy Drews, that really is saying something. Paul Sapsford, I'm not going to say anything on camera because you know I'll end up in tears. I'm going to miss you like mad. And finally, Gibbo, there really is nothing I can say because I know damn well I'm going to see you next week. We'll miss you all heaps. It won't be the same without you. Bye.